Hello there, Rob here again, and welcome to this hypnosis video for failure. Okay, let's get straight into it. So can you find yourself, please, somewhere comfortable to either sit or lie down with your legs uncrossed and your arms by your side. So if you're sitting down, your arms on the arms of the chair, or on your knees or on your thighs. If you're lying down, lie down on your back with your legs uncrossed and your arms by your sides. If this position is terribly uncomfortable for you, find yourself a comfortable position either on your side or your front, whatever works best for you. Okay, so I'd like you now just to close your eyes and just feel in to your breathing. So breathe in and out. In and out. In backwards now from 300, and with each number I want you to allow yourself to relax. Two nine nine, two nine eight. 297, 296. Just let yourself go and allow yourself to relax more and more. 295, 294, and relax your body. 293. Notice your feet and relax them as much as you can. 292, 291. Relax your shoulders and your hands. Relax your face and your eyes. Heavy. Just let yourself go. Think about failure. We can mean many different things. Because failure, in many respects, we should think of as a learning experience. And so when we feel that something hasn't been successful, we should reinterpret interpret it as being a learning experience. So in reality, failure doesn't really exist. It's just learning experiences. Learning experiences which help us on our way through to doing what we want. However, I think we all know that the negative side of failure is in our relationship to other people. And so when we feel we're being ridiculed and people are making fun of us because of our failure, this is something which we should separate. So we need to address these two things completely differently. When we are unsuccessful something that we do, we must separate the two things. The action which has been unsuccessful, we must learn to treat as a learning experience. Just in the same way as when we drive our car, we have to continually change direction. We can't just drive in a straight line. Even when the road is completely straight, we need to continually adjust and change. In the same way, whatever we do, we must learn that making mistakes all part of life, and we learn from it. But when we experience the negative attitude of other people, either when they criticize us or make us feel to be stupid, ridicule us, we must separate this from the learning experience. We cannot take responsibility for other people's attitudes, but we can change our interpretation of other people's words. so we can eliminate these bad memories very easily. We can eliminate these bad memories and experiences of people's negative words towards us very easily using hypnosis and EFT. And so you can address these problems of ridicule and the embarrassment that it causes us very easily by changing our interpretation of these things. And we can do this using hypnosis. And we can change our interpretation of the things that we have done by seeing them as a learning process. Think about great people from the past. Think about Albert Einstein. He was a very, very great man. He made some wonderful discoveries. He also made lots and lots of mistakes, and he needed to make these mistakes to make his wonderful discoveries. I always like to remember as well that Albert Einstein, musician, also a violinist. He was a terrible violinist. It gave him great pleasure. And his music, in fact, helped him. When he had a problem and he couldn't resolve it, when he had a problem with his experiments, his calculations, and he didn't know what to do, he would go and play the violin. And he wasn't a very good violinist. But when he played the violin, very often the solution to his problems would just come to him. And then he would go back to work. But Albert Einstein would have never made his fantastic discoveries if he had stopped when he made a mistake. Because he made many, many mistakes. And it was through his persistence and his continuing to learn from every mistake that he made his wonderful discovery. And so we can learn something from this. When we make mistakes, but unnecessary. our mistakes are necessary to us because we learn from these mistakes and they make us better people. But when we feel embarrassed or we feel ridiculed, name calling, and people making fun of us, this is because other people's weaknesses and lack of understanding. And we must take this separately. We could confront this in a sensible way, and we can guarantee overcoming it.